know, I think people have made things that spin in the wind for a long time, but he certainly took it to another level. He always called them windmills, and other people assigned the name whirligigs to them. The wind would turn a wheel, and that wheel would make something else happen.
Polly Simpson ran a wreck of service. He was a welder. He moved a lot of equipment into manufacturing companies here in Wilson. And a lot of that old equipment you now see out in the park on his whirligigs. Polly started making the whirligigs when he was 65 years old upon his retirement, and he worked on them for the next 25 plus years until he passed away. He used his old wreckers to erect them, but as he got into his late 80s and early 90s, he couldn't climb up on them and maintain them as he once had, and he realized that it would probably be a good idea to work out a mutually agreeable thing with the city to move them downtown and restore them, which is what we've been doing for the last 8 years. We're in front of the Polly Simpson Whirligig Conservation Headquarters. We got some really good conservation workers, and the more they do, the more they appreciate what Wallace did 30 years ago.
Tourists are coming from far and wide. They're visiting Wilson in droves to see this park, and it's not even finished yet. This is the only place in the world where you can see 30 of Wallace Simpson's large-scale kinetic whirligigs. Some are as tall as 50 feet or more and weigh as much as 10 tons. It's amazing to see them blow so easily in the wind. It doesn't take much of a breeze to get these massive sculptures moving.
All of Wallace's whirligigs have reflectors on them, and these are highway signs. And we've got special lighting in the park. You know, when you're driving down the highway and your headlights hit a highway sign? Well, this is a kaleidoscope of colors at night, and when they're spinning, it's just amazing. We've partnered with the North Carolina Arts Council, Department of Cultural Resources, and what this is going to mean for Wilson is called creative placemaking. We're using art and culture that was native to Wilson to, first of all, save the artwork. And by doing so, we're generating a stimulus for economic development.
We're seeing economic development in our downtown to the likes of which we haven't seen in, you know, maybe 75 years. So we've got about $30 million of redevelopment happening in downtown. We have lofts being created. We have new businesses, breweries, restaurants, things like that.
The weekly farmers market will be in the pavilion out there, and then we will have concerts. We will have programming year-round, and we will have educational components year-round. We've already got a curriculum that was developed in partnership with A-plus schools based on Wallace's whirligig. My mom was a high school physics teacher, and she was the first person to bring me out to the farm to show them to me. The museum, when it opens in the spring, will be a different sort of environment. You'll be able to get up close with smaller works and kind of see how he made these things. You'll be able to learn more about Wallace's story. And I think there are a lot of people that have seen these over the years and have an association or memories about them. So that excites me that people will be able to kind of see them again in their working conditions all together for the first time in quite a while.
He has whirligigs literally all over the world. In London, there are whirligigs in Moscow, I mean in New York City. Wallace made the comment, he said, "I never thought I would be an artist, but I guess I am."
The Wallace Simpson Whirligig Park is located at 301 Goldsboro Street South in historic downtown Wilson. The grand opening is Thursday, November 2nd, and you can expect a big crowd that day. The park will be open daily after that. For more information, check out their website at wilsonwhirligigpark.org.